Hello. Good evening, everybody. I was not expecting so many people here, but that's great because we have a great story to share with you and short one as well. So my name is Ari Vanttinen. I come from the company, probably the coolest grown-up startup company in Finland, Comptel. I typically hate giving money or losing money. Giving money to someone without getting something back immediately. This time, this is an exception. I do it with great pleasure. Let me explain. We organized our own anti-seminar on Monday or Tuesday this week called Next Today North. There was 500 business leaders from 45 countries. There, and now, later here at Slush, we have been doing some charity activity. And we wanted to raise money for the great, beautiful idea and program here in Finland called Me Hack It. And I have Reetta here with me to talk about shortly about Me Hack It. And how cool is that, Reetta?
Thank you, Ari. It's a pleasure to be here. Great to see so many people at Slush. Me Hack It is actually building coding and robotics education into high schools in Finland. So we want to give high school students hand-on technology skills in coding and robotics. And we all know how technological this world is, so we want these students to be able to navigate in this world.
Wow, beautiful. Having two kids myself, it's a great idea. How did we do this? How did people donate it and contribute it? Actually, we had this beautifully designed exercise bike, and that was equipped with our embedded predictive analytics algorithms. And each time you guys cycled, and based on your performance, Comptel would donate money. And so you put a real sweat equity in the Me Hack It program. And that was great. We ended up to the sum with all of you guys. Let me get it right. 5,226 euros. So on average, it was about 20 euros per each cyclist. Great. Thanks for that. So here we go. Here's the check from Comptel to Me Hack It program. And with this money, I hope at least one high school student or youngster, boy or girl, I don't mind, can experience and get inspired by technology and create something beautiful for all of us in the future. Thanks.
Thank you.
All right, let the show continue.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Slush Hacks. Yeah! Do you know what this is? Do you know what this is? It's the top prize tonight, and it comes with 20,000 euros in your pocket. Who wants to win? Who wants to win this? An amazing week in Helsinki, ladies and gentlemen. A historical week for Finnish hacks. Never in Finnish history have we had such a large, amazing hack in this country. This is the biggest hackathon in Europe. Isn't that amazing? And from now on, we're going to make it the biggest hackathon in the world. Yeah! Isn't that cool? And this has happened because we had amazing collaboration. I'm going to put it here so it doesn't fall. Oh, no. I'm going to keep it. Amazing collaboration between four hackathons. We had the people from architecture, engineering, and construction have their own hackathon this week. We had people from industry focusing on energy and networks, and called the industry hack. And then we had the people from Altus and the unbelievable long list of collaboration people bringing in over 500 people from 30 countries to that hackathon. And then we had the Ultra Hack with as many people from over 15 countries altogether, over 40 countries, 1,000 hackers in this city. Isn't that cool? Yeah! I'm so excited about this event that I changed my name. It's MC Hacker. It's my real name, Shaker, you know. But I'm the MC of the evening. You can call me MC Hacker tonight, just for you, ladies and gentlemen. So we're going to start the evening, and it's going to be a really exciting evening. We have 17 challenges, 17 teams, 17 pitches. They will have between 3 and 4 minutes to pitch. And tonight, the jury, do we have the jury members? Where are you? Where's the jury?
Here.
Are you awake?
Yeah!
Good. Three guys. Whatever you do, smile to this corner right here. Don't forget that. You know, it's a bit like, you know, synchronized, you know, dancing or skating. You gotta be nice to the jury members. All right. Good luck to you. Make a good decision. And we're gonna get us started, ladies and gentlemen, with the AEC Hackathon people. As I mentioned, it was the architecture, engineering, and construction people. They were all weekend, but about 14 teams hacked solutions for real-world industry problems at Tekla. Tekla's a really cool Finnish company. A lot of, you know, 3D animations of what you can do with construction. Very cool place in Espoo. The hacks varied from new immersive customer experiences and buying a home to better information management and facilities management and apps for indoor navigation. The winner of that hack, of the AEC hack, was Indoor Hackers! Get over here! The team was able to solve a big industry problem by creating easy-to-use interface and interactive and 3D building information models with useful features like indoor positioning, which is really, really hard to do. When your GPS doesn't work anymore and you're indoors, these guys are going to help you. Where are you? Are you ready? I'm going to give you 3 to 4 minutes. Come and pitch. Give him a big hand. Big hand. Yes. Yes.
There's no registration needed because you already have the NFC tag that's used with the electric vehicle chargers. So you just tap the NFC and you're good to go. It's affordable to implement. We can remotely update both the hardware and the app. And so why did we build this thing? Basically because Tesla and Nissan Leaf have created a huge momentum in electric cars. And the more cars people buy, the queues will become bigger. Let's take a system look in the wild, what it looks like. Yeah.
So this is our working prototype. And as you can see, it already contains all the required elements. The app, cloud, and the charger work seamlessly together. If you got interested, we have a live demo for you to show. Come to see us after the show.
In the future, we can also automatically update the route and reserve the chargers automatically at the right intervals. We can also ask other users to reserve, like free up a charger for us. And then we are looking for cooperation with electric charger providers and car manufacturers and anybody really who's interested in electric vehicle charging. Thank you.
Yes.
Great job.
Yes, loistava. Great job. We all got a charge out of that. Thank you very, very much. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to start with our third hack group. This is a huge group of people. Over 500 people from 30 countries attended the Junction hack over the weekend. How many of you attended the Junction? Can I hear you? That's a big group. Altos, yes. I have to say that, you know, I'm a former Alto guy myself. I wish you all very well. All right. 140 projects, ladies and gentlemen. And what's really, really cool about this particular hack, they had 240 partner representatives visited the venue to help, you know, these hackers, you know, with their projects. So we have like really, really cool hacks. We're going to start with the first one. And oh, yeah, one thing they asked me to mention is that they had a lot of student volunteers helping over the weekend. Any of them here today? Student volunteers? Oh, that's who you were. Student volunteers. There you are. Fantastic energy. The first is Future Labs Challenge. And in this challenge, the objective of the Future Lab track was to build a device-based service. And the winner of the track was OkMuse. Get up here. Give him a big hand. Solves the problem of not having to memorize sheet music. Oh, I love this. And you don't have to change the sheet music when you play. I want it now. You've got 3 minutes. Good luck.
Did you know that it could take almost a year for a musician to memorize a piece for their performance? Let me tell you a story. I'm a musician. I was playing in an international piano competition. And I've played through the pieces that I knew not so well, really fine. And I started playing the last piece that I thought I knew really, really, really well. I started playing, thinking about my victory and everything. But then I stopped. My memory went completely blank. I started again, I started playing, and I stopped at the same spot. The audience was completely silent. The judges were completely silent. I didn't know what to do. This is the piece I still remember by now. I was only 9 years old back then, but I still remember this piece.
Well, I'm also a musician, and I have to tell you that this is a common problem for all musicians, regardless of how professional they are, the problem of memory lapses in the middle of a performance. It's been scientifically proven that music memorization is a lot more difficult than memorizing, for example, lyrics or poetry. And that's because, as you can see, there are four different types of memories involved while memorizing music. There's simply so much information to handle at the same time as you're performing. And
that's why we created this app for Google Glass, OkMuse. What does it do? You're performing, you don't need a music stand anymore. You can perform at your own pace. It follows you, it follows your pace. You're playing faster, it goes faster. You're playing slower, it goes slower. It turns the music sheets for you. So you can access all your notes just by having the glass with you, anywhere.
And now, here we have a basic diagram of how it works. But now I want to actually show how it works. So next slide. Yeah, so now you should imagine that you're a pianist. You put the glass on, you go to our app, you choose the piece, and you start playing. Immediately when you choose the piece, the beginning of the piece is shown in the glass display. As you continue playing at your own pace and tempo, it automatically scrolls it for you. It's not distracting you because it's on the side of your vision, but it's always for you to have a quick glance when you need to.
And it actually is more visible because it's white on black, not black and white, so you can actually see it in your Google Glass. We've asked many musicians about the app, and they told that they would need it 100%. And there was actually one guy coming to talk to us after Junction. He told, guys, I'm playing trombone, and I really think that I need this, because you remember those military stands and all? We can understand him. This app can be used not only for professional musicians, but also for amateurs or people who learn music.
Well, the number you see there consists of only symphony orchestra professional musicians in Europe. Now, if you add to that all the amateur musicians, soloists, even professional musicians from chamber orchestras, bands, other places, you see that the number rises really high. And we believe that there is demand.
And we envision a whole orchestra with Google Glass just playing by it. Here's our team. We have the knowledge and the expertise to make this happen. And now it's all up to you to make this happen and hear beautiful performances wherever you go.
Take a bow. Great job. You're musicians, right?
Yeah. Oh. We're at the band. We have performance next week on the Wednesday.
Oh, they get a pizza from Julius Elioff from Junction. And Emily Kontala from Futurize are giving pizzas to everybody who participated in this hack. Isn't that cool? Yes.
Thank you very much. Very creative use of existing technology to create, get something really useful for Google Glass. Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Very, very cool. Give him a big Can I try those glasses? Can I try that? That's very, very, okay, oh, wow. How, oh, there it is, but that's for the nose. Right? Oh, this is very cool. Okay, bye-bye. Very, very cool. So, hey, the next hack is the future of payments with Klarna. Klarna is, the objective of the future, you know, of payment. How do you make payment a lot easier? How do you make payment a lot more simple? And this is a really, really cool hack. They call it Taplicious. Get over here, Taplicious. Give them a big hand. You know, they remove the hassle of having to pay for what you eat in restaurants. You know, when the check comes, it's always a little bit problematic.
Yeah.
You have a solution.
We have a solution.
You have 3 minutes to tell us about it.
Awesome.
All right.
All
right.
So, hey, everyone. We're Taplicious, and we're going to revolutionize the restaurant experience you guys have almost every day. So the why are we making this? Basically two problems. So first one is waiting. No one likes waiting. You have to wait for waiters a lot. Second one is splitting the bill. You always end up with your friends doing complicated calculations, who pays what, etc. There's got to be an easier way, no? So our solution. To give you like a really clear image, I'm just going to walk you through it. So it's basically an app that allows you to order and check out on your phone. So you check, you log in with any social media platform. It takes you to the check-in screen. This is where you go to the restaurant with your friends. You check in at your table using the QR code or the NFC chip that's on your table. Your friends do the same thing. And in this case, it's our friend Robert, and he's sitting at this table with his friend Noortje, and they're checked in at this table, and they want to place an order. So they go over to orders, they say, okay, we want to place a new order, takes them to the menu. First, they want some drinks, so they go over to drinks, they select some stuff, and they go over to the order overview. This is where you can see what you're about to order, what your friend is about to order, and the total cost of the order. So they place the order, and this is the moment that the order comes in at the kitchen and they can bring over the drinks. So they place a couple of different orders throughout the night and have a nice main course, etc. And at the end of the night, they say, okay, we want to go home, we want to check out. They can do this in the restaurant. They can even do this at home after they've left. So they click checkout, they get the receipt, and they can pay their restaurant visit. Like, we have a lot of different payment methods, but we of course recommend Klarna because it provides really easy one-click payment. And then we're like, okay, thank you for eating with Taplicious. We hope you come again soon. And they can view their restaurant visit in their history for administrative purposes and all that good stuff. Okay, so that's the user side of things, but what about restaurants? This is also super interesting. Okay, so restaurants have their own panel in which they can like manage their menu and all that good stuff, right? But they also have analytics. So they also have analytics because we have people log in with their social media platforms. That means we get a lot of data from them. We can anonymously store, and we want to do what Google Analytics did for websites. We want to do that for restaurants. What's also really cool is that we get a lot of data ourselves. So what we can do with that is things like intelligent menus. Okay, so say you really like cocktails, and every night at 10 p.m. you go out to a bar, you have a cocktail. We know that you like cocktails because you do that every day. So after you've done that for a while, you go to a bar at 10 p.m., and we can, of course, present you with recommended cocktails with discount, of course, because you do that stuff a lot. Then also, I'm a Dutchie, I'm from Holland. If I go out to Italy, I don't speak Italian, I don't know what's on the menu. So we know what country you're from, Taplicious knows what country you're from, and we can attempt to auto-translate the menu for you to your native language. The possibilities are basically endless. These are just a few of the options you have. A better restaurant experience for everyone involved,
taplicious.com. Thank you very much.
You made us hungry. Stay here. We have a pizza delivery for you, too. In the corner. Take a picture, guys. Take a picture. Pizza picture. You can go there, too. Why don't you go there, too? All right. Yes. Looking hungry.
Awesome. So the corner track was super cool. It was all about the future of payments. We had some awesome company or awesome teams building awesome hacks for the weekend. Unfortunately, Klarna people are already on their way back to Sweden, but it was a truly cool track, and we will actually build in the future. So give one more big round of applause for the awesome teams.
Thank you guys, thank you. Yes, what a delicious service. Hey, this next one is really cool. It's health with if insurance. Well, it creates a preemptive healthcare service, you know, to support a healthier life. You know, think of like Siri for healthcare. So you've got, you know, your social media and all the kinds of stuff you put, you know, positive words, and then you've got all this monitoring going on, you know, your wearable technology. You know, you hack this and you find out, you know, are you doing well? Are you in good shape? And then if you are, your insurance company will give you a bonus or will give you some kind of perk. So the people working on who won this track in the insurance track here, Health with If Insurance, are a company called, or a group called, Lifestyle Rewards. Get up here. Man, good luck. You've got 3 minutes. Yes. Woo.
Hello. We are a Lifestyle Rewards team, and we would like to help you to improve yourself. Do you remember the last time you had an interaction with your insurance company? Most people do not. As an insurance company, what if you would engage more positively with your customers? What are the problems we are facing today? They are that health data is hard to come by. It's expensive, and there is a low penetration of biosensors. Traditional indicators like smoking, salary, diabetes, become less effective than in risk management comparing to new methods. Companies would like better understanding of their customers. They need better risk management tools as well. Person's social activity is a leading risk tool to determine, to say about the person's health. So comparing to traditional tools like income, smoking, and diabetes, it provides more information about the person's health. What is the solution? Insurance company can set a list of goals for each specific customer, and by meeting the goal, you can get insurance benefits. For example, you can set social activity goal where you reward people by their positive social interaction. There is a huge variety of goals that could be set. So, as I said, by succeeding in one of them, you can get various insurance benefits. Our product is an application that allows insurance companies to set goals for each specific customer. What is the value we provide? So health data is hard to come by, and it's much cheaper and easier to get social media data. By interacting with the customer, companies can build more trustful relationship with them. Everyone uses social media. There is 20% of world population on Facebook. And comparing to 1 to 5% of biosensor penetration, it's a huge difference. How does it work? You choose your goal, and then you need to meet it. So meaning you need to succeed in all the criteria. Later you get bonus. So either insurance benefits, either special offers. together with employers and insurance companies. We would like to improve people's lifestyles by rewarding them for their efforts. So we are a lifestyle rewards team, and we would like, we want healthier and happier people. Thank you.
How do you feel? Well, you're a bit nervous?
Yes, of course.
And you did great. Now you've got your pizza.
Oh, thanks.
And we have also a great announcement from IF, something really interesting about your pitch.
So you're never going to believe this. We're so happy with your hack that we hope that last year we did a similar hack. And the thing that won, we actually developed that into an app that we launched across the Nordics with a multi-million euro campaign. It was on TV. We hope that we can continue to work with you guys, that we can do something similar with you guys and actually launch this as something great with a multi-million dollar or euro TV campaign across the Nordics.
What do you say? What do you say?
If I knew that, I would have prepared better for my pitch. Definitely.
Thank you, Anders, from IF Insurance. My God. Isn't this exciting? This stuff actually works. It's super cool. It's super cool. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the next hack was Future of Commerce with Shopify. Well, you know, they wanted to build something that brings simple function and high value to merchants that enables them to do something they never thought possible. That's a big, big hack, okay? But I think that these guys hacked it and really nailed it. You know, their products help sell products over chat using artificial intelligence built into when you chat, it sort of identifies the words, and then with natural language processing, and makes the shopping experience a lot more exciting. Please welcome Chat First. Get over here. Yes, good luck. 3 minutes.
Thank you. Hi. Imagine the world where you do not need any mobile application to call an Uber, to order a food, to control your smart house. You need only chat to do this. Imagine the world where you can order anything you wish directly from salesmen through the chat. Imagine the chat first world. Hi, my name is Pavel and has my team, Chat First. We are a group of experienced professionals in different technologies. On our team, we have a future PhD on computer science. We have experienced growth hacker. We have great visionaries. We come here on last weekend to participate in Hack Junction Hackathon. For 24 hours, we created minimal viable product of what we called Siri for online and mobile businesses. And we actually won a e-commerce, future of e-commerce track hosted by Shopify on this. Why e-commerce, you ask? E-commerce is huge market, and even tiny piece of it, it's extremely impressive. So let's take owner of small shop. Every day, he should answer a lot of questions from a lot of customers through various channels. And our shop owner is unable to lead an appropriate dialogue with all his potential customers. He lack of time and he lose his customers. He may be tired of annoying repeatable questions and he lose his customers. He may have insufficient knowledge in sales and he lose his customers. We have to stop it. We created a web service to automate communication between clients and company by constructing artificial intelligence robot capable to communicate on natural language. After that, we constructed a virtual sales assistant. We call it SalesBot, to assist a shop owner on his way to shop to see his customers. Let's see how it works. Imagine you're a girl and you want to buy a coat. You open chat of the shop and just asking, hey, I want to buy a coat. After that, shop determines that you're a girl and introduces you some trendy coats. And after that, it drives you all the way right to the checkout. It asks what your size you need, what color do you prefer, where to deliver it, pay for it, and other stuff. And perform checkout. Bam, it's done. You just bought a code through contextual user interface. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, our bots are completely omnichannel. It supports third-party API, natural language, and custom scenarios. For now, we support only several channels, but much more channels will be added soon. There are some competitors in this market, but we can beat them with seamless integration, easy scenario expanding, and ability to actual sale through our chatbots. We platform a service, so we will charge shop owners for $40 per month. Also, we will charge additionally for custom scenarios, for services of language engineer to improve these scenarios. We did a great job, and our product's almost ready. All what we need is seed round investment and partners to help us automate first clients. So please, join us in Chat First World. Thank you. Here's my contacts, right anytime. Also, I want to invite my team here on the stand. Thank you.
And you've got more pizza coming your way.
Yes.
Would you want to say something? Yes, take the mic and tell us. Shopify.
Hey, I'm Josh from Shopify. And we had an amazing weekend on the Future of Commerce track.
It's selfie time.
7 or 8 hacks, all of which were improving merchants' lives, and judging was really, really, really difficult. And we picked this hack because it's a strong vision just to make the lives of merchants and consumers much easier. So extra round of applause for Pavel and the team at Chat First.
You're a big hand. Thank you, Josh, for that. Thank you very much. Super, great. The next hack had a wonderful partner for it. It had Uber part of this. It's called Improving Cities with Uber was this challenge. It's the use of the Uber API to build the best app with the most impact. Well, what can it be for Uber? Well, this one was a really cool one. It's Uber for kids. So how can kids use Uber and the Uber service, of course, with the permission of their parents and making the most of that service for the kids' needs. Very, very interesting application of Uber by what they called, and they call themselves, well, Uber Kids. Get up here. You got 3 minutes, good luck. Yes.
Hello, everyone. I know you're gonna be really excited about this because today we might actually change the future of Uber. I'm from a team called Uber Kids, and last weekend we participated in the Junction Hackathon. We were selected as the winners of the Uber track. We built a working prototype that uses Uber's API for the busy parents to take their kids from back and forth from home to school, from school to the after-class activities. And we want Uber to do that for them, and we're calling it Uber Family. Uber Family also works as a safer alternative of the public transportation or the regular cabs. While the app is targeted at the parents, it is built for the kids, meaning that the kids himself can request the Uber ride without need of parents' interaction. It's missing one slide. How it works is like really simple, that all the parents need to do is to preset the destinations for their child's trip. So for example, I'm currently in the high school, I want to go home. I just open the app, I just choose from the list like home, I click it, Uber gets my current location and already knows the destination, while the parent gets notified when I called the Uber, when the driver picked me up, and when they brought me to the destination. We conducted a survey where we found out that 75% of the parents find this as a problem, and interestingly, 100% of the parents who used Uber before would use this for their kids. Although we faced a drawback because currently under Uber's terms of service, this service would be against their terms of service because individuals under 18 years old cannot be in the Uber ride alone. So we had to, for this reason, we pivoted our idea from the kids towards the family, especially on the elderly people who are unable to drive by themselves. So we enable them to get around. this is the slide. This is how the app could look like, but actually, it doesn't look like that. I want to say that regulations and rules of the service can change. We just need to think what people want and need. While focusing on the future, because this is the only way how the change can happen. Thank you.
All right, bring on the pizza. Great job, man. Woo! More pizza.
So, my name is Adam Oren. I'm from Developer Relations at Uber, and I just want to congratulate these guys. They've come up with a remarkable idea. It's amazingly simple, and one of the reasons that we chose them was not because of the just simplicity that they could bring to our API and our application, but the idea that they were able to pivot during the hackathon. They found a problem with their idea. They didn't give up. They didn't throw it away and say, you know what, we can't build something for kids. They changed it around. They had a fierce spirit and built something that they could actually market and go and put on the App Store tomorrow using our API and go to market with. So that's the fierceness, the entrepreneurial thing that we like to see done with our API. And this is just massive kudos to these guys for pulling off an amazing, simple, well-refined product in the course of about 48 hours.
Super. So
thank you, guys.
Thank you, Adam. Adam, when are we going to see Uber in Finland?
Uber in Finland? It's here. I took an Uber to get here today.
It works well. I haven't used it yet.
it does.
Yes,
that's
I'm so happy.
And that's and, all
and,
home.
And for my kids, when do I get it?
As soon as these guys put something on the App Store.
You see, that's a promise.
Tomorrow?
Super, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you, Adam, for coming. Thank you so much. Give him a big hand, everybody. Yes. I love that company. Hey, and the next hack is an unlimited hack. In this track, the objective was to build anything that didn't fit into any of the other categories. And, this one was a really cool one. It actually, you know, allows people to learn coding in a fun and new way by competing against their friends. And these people are called Slush Smackdown. Come on up. Yes.
Slush Smackdown is code school on steroids. We're a bunch of geeks who love building stuff, but we felt that the barrier to learn coding is too high, and we want to pay forward and inspire others, especially non-techies, to start coding and building. So we build proof of concept that offers more social interaction and participation than any other coding platform. It's a gateway drug where people get addicted to coding before we move them on to harder things. So in Slush Smackdown, you build code, a logic to your character, how they will wrestle against other people's code. We use the actual commands in the visual editor to teach people programming languages. And we show them in real time updated JavaScript to make the transitioning to real programming languages easier. So let's test our code and challenge our dear friend, Sika Pankkiri. Oh, you always battle with real code against source code built by other people. And yes, Joe Rampage is teaching a lesson to Sika Pankkiri. It took us 48 hours from the idea to launching the game and coding school on Sunday evening. And here's a couple of highlights I'd like to point out what we achieved over the Junction weekend. Most coding environments offer either visual or textual programming. We wanted to combine them and make learning faster and easier by showing JavaScript updated real time as you build your code. For the more advanced students, we offer full-blown JavaScript editor where you can program anything. But we had to protect our servers from nasty things, and we put the JavaScript interpreter into a sandbox. Most importantly, we wanted to motivate people by having real-time live interaction with their friends and other people online, where they battle with their code and challenge others. We've been thrilled to see that people came to our coding school, and more importantly, that they've been bringing their friends along. So here are the stats from yesterday. We had almost 400 signups there who had played almost 14,000 code battles. And they keep coming back as the average number of code battles per user is increasing. And yesterday it was about 40 battles per user. And just before coming on stage, I checked the figures. And now we are up to 30,000 code battles already. So we are thrilled that we have hit something important and really got people addicted to coding. We apparently ruined several people's workday, and we are now looking forward to take coding forward and helping other people to start coding and getting inspired to build stuff. Thank you.
You get a pizza. This time we have Julius. You're not y'all. Come on, you shouldn't eat the guy's pizza, Julius.
That's so
these
good.
Guys from Aalto University, you know, it's terrible. Shame on you.
Thank you, Andre.
Saako minäkin?
Cello. Yeah. Take your own.
Ihana.
I have bacteria.
No niin. Mikä
I'm
tää
hugely
on?
Impressed.
Kinkku ananas.
Mate, turn off the microphone. I'm hugely impressed.
You speak.
With all our teams at the Junction, and especially Slush Smackdown. At first, I couldn't believe that you could actually build that in 48 hours, but these guys did it, so huge round of applause to Junction and all teams, and especially Slush Smackdown.
Respect! Very, very, very cool stuff. Hey, how many of you in the room are afraid, or at least a little bit afraid of flying? Anybody? Anybody a little bit, just a little bit afraid of flying? You know, well, this next app or this next hack is going to help you out, ladies and gentlemen. This track was called the Aero track. The objective was to build something that would improve the travel experience. And this really helps your aviophobia. And of course, the winner of the track was Fear of Flying. Come on up.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're Coder Coded, and we're here to present to you apps and ideas to beat aviophobia. Fear of flying, that's an unspoken, very serious problem. It's been estimated that about 30% of people feel anxious at some stage when they're flying. And, for example, here, 15,000 attendees at Slush, 4,500 would feel uncomfortable flying here. And we are targeting and reaching these people in flight. New airplanes, they have Wi-Fi and they are equipped with a web server. When the passengers use their own devices to join the Wi-Fi, they are presented a landing page. And we are introducing a new content category to this in-flight portal that the users, the passengers, can use the apps with their own devices. During the 48-hour hackathon, we built four different web apps that tackle different kind of fears. First one, can the plane take it? We're going to attach an accelerometer to the web server. And when the plane is experiencing, you can see on the lower left corner, the plane is shaking and the trays are flying, and the passenger can see that everything is normal. The plane has been designed to actually take this. So the people who are afraid that the plane will break apart in flight can probably find relief from this kind of app. Next one, mood meter. It might be embarrassing to actually admit to the cabin crew that you're afraid. Whether it's aviophobia, or whether it's another passenger, for example, who's causing the anxiety. So we are providing you a mood meter, a very simple app, a slider, so to say, here, seen on the left side, that you can use to communicate with the cabin crew. And on the right side, you can see the cabin crew view, where they can see this heat map of seats, where when they see a lot of red coming in some parts of the plane, they can react in a discreet manner. So you don't have to shout out over people that I'm afraid. I think this is a very clever idea. Next one. It sounds funny. There are people who listen to all the sounds that the airplane makes and wonder whether it's normal. We're providing an airplane soundtrack that includes all the normal sounds that the plane makes. So when you're traveling, flying, and you hear different kinds of sounds, you're provided these sounds and the explanations for those sounds. So when you learn, your fear goes away. Fun in the turbulence. Yes, turbulence is something that a lot of people are afraid of. We thought that we want to make it the other way around. Turbulence should be anticipated, waited. Something fun should happen during the turbulence. So we thought of games that would reward you the more there's turbulence. And then we implemented another funny thing. We have a jolly face of a Finnish president wobbling in sync with the bumpy air. And of course, if this doesn't relax you, we also did a highly scientific study at Hack Junction and found out that there's a lot of people who also find this relaxing. Okay, this is coder-coded apps and ideas to beat aviophobia. Thank you.
Well, woo! Really cool. Thank you. My wife thanks you. She's afraid of flying. Thank you so much for doing this.
No problem.
Yes. Yes, it's right, the right that you have two to choose from. Pick one up and tell us. Aero.
Well, thank you very much. First things first, you're going to need something to wash that down with. and second, Finnair, Finavian Reactor first got together thinking, we need to encourage people from all over the world with talent and vision. We need to provide them with the one thing that's often missing, is that opportunity to make a difference, that opportunity to redefine the next few years of an industry. These guys have shown the way, and these guys, not only did they push the envelope in terms of humor and functionality, but they're showing the airline industry that it is possible to be very, very customer-oriented, very traveler-oriented, and to create things that are native in-flight experiences. Mm. This is exactly what these guys want, because there's so much potential. And the more that onboard connectivity penetrates the industry, the larger the market for these types of experiences is going to grow. So first of all, a really big hand for the team that won, the Coder-Coder team. Thank Woo-hoo. You. And second of all, I know that you guys have been thanked to no end, but we could not get out of here without being fair to Julius's team, Dan, Keke, Rico, everybody. It escapes me.
Get up here.
Yona,
get up here, guys. Get up
every
here.
Every single person. Henny, where are you guys?
Take a bow. Come on.
These guys have toiled, sweat, cried, bled for all of these massive events. And a lot of the guys are students. And look at what they've done. They've brought a whole bunch of corporations to truly think of the future and to invite the people that can actually make a difference. Yes. So if these guys don't deserve a round of applause, who does?
Yeah.
Give it up. Louder.
Thank you. Thank you, Fernando.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Fantastic, guys. Thank you. Oh, more, more, more. You're hitting us hard. Yes.
Thanks, man. Thank you, guys.
Okay, strike a pose, all of you. Look at that energy. Give it up for these young people. Come on. Okay, very, very cool.
No, this is your show. I'm off.
All right, take a bow together.
Thank
One,
you.
Two, three, and take a bow. Woo! Yes. Yes, give him a big hand. Woo, what energy. Thank you, Junction. Awesome, thank you very much. Okay, now get off the stage, please. Enough already. Thank you very much for that. Very good. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now we're gonna start with the last hack. This is also an unbelievable hackathon last weekend. The atmosphere was unbelievable. 500 participants, almost 20 countries involved, and 100 projects were built during a single weekend. Also amazing. All of these four hacks were just amazing that they all happened together, making it the biggest hackathon in Europe. Did I mention that to you before? Isn't that worth an applause one more time? It's amazing. It's amazing when you put your mind to things, what you can get, what you can achieve. So ladies and gentlemen, for UltraHack, what's a really pretty cool thing is that I hear that the people from UltraHack can go and have something to drink. Isn't that nice? There's beer and stuff. You can come and pick it up. I was told to tell you that. So so we had a huge collaboration between, of course, startups, students, technology associations, really super companies.
you know, and over 50 supporting partners. We're going to start with the 10th hack today on Health Games track, and this was for the new children's hospital. The track challenge was how to help children to experience a more enjoyable hospital visit with new technology. You know, it's really stressful for a young person to go into the hospital. So how do you make that, you know, less stressful? With outcomes, a happier hospital environment could be created. These guys had a great idea for all children in need of rehabilitation in hospital, had a home, prepare at home. It's big fun and extensive opportunities to scale. Also, for adult purposes, who gets a little bit nervous when they go to the hospital? Anybody? It's normal, and these guys are going to help you, and they're called Rehaboo! Get up here!
Hi, guys. So, physical rehabilitation is boring, and especially if you're a child. We're here to change that. Rehaboo is our motion-capturing game that works hand-in-hand with traditional physiotherapy. It disguises exercises into a fun game, and this can be done with PC and Kinect.
With Rehaboo, children would actually do what they are told in physiotherapy. So, we got happier kids, faster results, and lower costs. Now we are going to show you a video of our demo.
Hopefully.
So, this was exercise for upper back area. And the player must perform the move correct to proceed in the game. The demo was created in only 48 hours during the UltraHack last weekend. So imagine what we can do if we get more time and more money. This is Boo, our mascot. Boo will guide and encourage players through the game, giving voice instructions. So, the game is suitable for every age, and reading skills are not required.
That's right. And right now, we have an amazing team and workspace, and we are really ready to make Rehaboo happen. The finished game will include a huge movement bank, warm-up moves, and a stretching guide. We created our idea with a new Finnish children's hospital in mind. And we figured that if the best of the best loves it, then the rest of them are going to like it too. So we want Rehaboo to be used in every hospital in the world. And the best part is, of course, that you can take it home and keep practicing after that. So, physical rehabilitation is boring. We want to change that with Rehaboo. Rehaboo makes faster results, happier kids, lower costs. We have 16 seconds, so say hi to our gang. Thank you. Helsinki hooligans.
Thank you so much. We've got Pekka Laadeni from the Children's Hospital who wants to give you something.
Yeah, thank you very much, guys. On behalf of the new Children's Hospital, I really want to tell you that we were amazed, inspired, and impressed about the level of all the three finalists. The games and apps they could create within 48 hours were great. And we are really looking forward to co-develop the game into real use in the future Children's Hospital. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Rehaboo! Thank you! Thank you for all those kids you're going to de-stress, and especially a lot of my friends who are really stressed about hospitals. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. All right, our next track was a really exciting track. It was the Smart City and Civic Tech track. Now,
two organizations banded their energies and brains together, the city of Helsinki and Open Knowledge Finland. As we know, Finland is known around the world for its openness of systems, and the city of Helsinki is a wonderful example of open technology and open systems that other small companies and big companies can plug into. These two joint forces in this track, and it actually was the most popular and competitive in the Ultra Track weekend, with 26 highly competitive teams. 26 teams were just in this track, and we're going to see the best one coming up on stage in just a second. So the winning team, and I saw them pitch. I got to tell you, personally, I think it's one of the best pitches I have heard so far. So I'm really speaking you up now. You were really good over the weekend. Don't disappoint me. You understand me? All right. They brought groundbreaking solution for citizens to influence. Citizen taking action and saying, hey, with this app, I can influence the way my city works, the way my city could work better, how things can be cheaper, how things can be more fun, more useful, more functional. And well, we're gonna give it to the butterflies to tell us about this. Butterlfy Effect! Yes! Yes.
Do I use this one? Okay, so I come from a city that is located between the border of Mexico and United States. Living there was a chaos. When I was a kid, I really wanted to have a magic wand, to fix all the problems, because I felt that I didn't have any voice in my community. Now, a few years ago, I moved to Finland, and I serve in the urban planning board in Tampere. And, Finland is leader in education. It's the least corrupted country in the world, but still, there is a gap between citizens and the city. So I started to think, how can we enhance the urban planning process? And the answer was just right in front of me. Get the users to participate in the urban planning of their cities. They are the eyes of the city. You are the eyes of the city. So how do we do that? In the one hand, we have a very outdated process of urban planning. We have phone calls, meetings, a lot of town hall meetings, etc. In the other hand, we are living on an era where social media and open data are very important. And you know what's the funny thing about open data? It's like teenage sex. You think that everybody's doing it, but in reality, no one is. And this is funny because the smart city industry is worth $20 billion. And then we have also 3.7 billion users using mobile apps. So how does this connect? And this is where Butterlfy Effect comes into connection. We want to create, there's a problem with the slides. We want to create a citizen-centered method of crowdsourcing. My slides are going crazy and I'm not even touching them. The city-centered method of crowdsourcing, yeah? Crowdsourcing solutions for a more vibrant, innovative urban environment. So how does it work? In the one hand, we have the community. On the other hand, we have the city of Helsinki. Then the Butterlfy Effect comes in between that. And it's the link that leverages open data, social media, into a citizen, more participatory democracy. Now, let's take Kala Satama, a thing that is happening currently in Helsinki. They are building an urban area. They plan to build by 2030, 7,000 dwellings, commerce, etc. Very controversial. So instead of waiting 15 years for everything to go on, users can start participating in the urban planning process. So how it works is they take a picture with an app that they already have in their phone, like Instagram. Take what they don't like, hashtag that as your plan, your city. This comes to our platform, where people can vote and debate about the projects they have. Now, as an architect, the most popular ones go on the top. And as an architect, then, I know where I want to build. But then I need to know why. And this is why we have created a complementary app. This app is a hub that adds practicality to the user. He can search for my parking near me, vote for proposals in the city. In the back end, we are measuring how the user behaves in the city and how they move through it. And this we provide as insight to our client, which will be able to make educated decisions in the planning of the city. Now, our business model is very easy. The Butterlfy Effect creates a free app for the community. The community generates data. With that data, we open it for everyone, but we provide insights to the city of Helsinki. The city of Helsinki, in return, provides funding for us. We also have other partners, like real estate, tourism offices, servant industry, and foundations such as Rockefeller Center and the Gates Foundation. Now, we won 250,000 euros and strategic advisors that are as passionate and mission-driven as us. On the first year, we want to accomplish 10,000 Instagram users, and we want to provide insights to the city of Helsinki by the end of the year. Now, how do we pull this off? My team is very international. We come from all over the world, and we plan to replicate this in New York City, in Silicon Valley, in Australia. We can replicate this because social media and participatory design are scalable. We will then later provide the feedback from Helsinki City of open data to other cities. Now, if you don't have 250,000 euros, but are as passionate and driven to co-invent the city in a more vibrant, innovative idea, start using the hashtag #YourPlanYourCity. Thank you.
Right on time. Good job. Stay here. All right. Do we have anybody? Yes, do we have could you come on stage, please? He's shy to give you your prize. Come on for the photo op. Center stage. Give her a hand one more time. Wasn't that a great, great pitch?
Yeah, thank you.
You want to say something?
Yeah, so hi, my name is Teemu. I'm from the Open Knowledge Finland. We did the track together with the city of Helsinki. The city of Helsinki, together with Open Knowledge Finland, really appreciate the diversity of the team. We appreciate the passion for learning that you showed over the weekend. And we appreciate the use of open democracy, the use of open data for open democracy. So we are, together with the city of Helsinki, fans of you right now. Thank you.
Participatory democracy. That was a really cool term. Thank you so much. Give them both a hand. Thank you so much. How many of you went to see or saw the Nieminen-Federer game on TV or went to see the game this week? Yeah, it was an amazing, amazing tennis match. And, you know, one of the rare moments in Finland living here, I was stuck in a traffic jam before the game. And I got there late. I was so pissed off. I used all the swear words I know in Finnish. So, God, man, there's a traffic jam. I hate who has at least once been stuck in a traffic jam. Well, the next team has a solution for us all, for all the cities in the world. This was the Mobility as a Service track by Telia Sonora. It was a dual challenge involving intelligent transport systems and automotive. Basically, what this team has done is, you know, brought an approach, a solution to encourage people to use public transportation with bonus points, and at the same time create a meaningful information and data for better city planning. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Points. Yes.
Yeah. Well, it's really exciting to be up here. My name is Darren, and together with my team during UltraHack, we developed Points. Points is a simple idea to reward citizens that use public transport. The way it works is that whenever you use public transport, like buses, trams, or you spend time in shopping centers, you park in parking spaces, you earn points that immediately go to your mobile phone. And these points can be spent at the favorite retailers or shopping centers in the city center. We were looking at the open data from some cities, and this is an example from Tampere. The city of Tampere has a plan that nowadays they have 1.2 million transactions in traveling shops, and they want to increase it to 2.2 million. 12% of that happens when people use bus, and data shows that people that use public transportation spend more time and more money. So increasing that to 30% means more revenue and more green cities. So residents get these points. they immediately come to your phone, there's nothing extra, and then you can spend these points at your favorite retailers or collect together with your friends and family. So let's say you have points from Stockman that you don't want to use, you send them to your sister and she buys her favorite dress. The next part is creating a three-point incentive. So we have citizens, we have the city, now we need a third to work, and that is businesses. Once we have all the incentives, now we take the data that we gather, all the information where people come from, where do they travel, how much they spend, and then we give this back to the business, and that's how our monetization and where we make the money. So businesses get to know their customers better, get better retention, see which locations perform better in which parts and which areas of the city. What we built during UltraHack is right now live on Azure servers. We built a front and back end to do this. We have, to summarize, I would like to remind that we have 3 points of incentive for citizens to spend their points and their favorite retailers get discounts, for cities to have more public transportation, greener cities, and use that data for better urban planning, and for businesses to improve their customer relationship and get more data from how their customers are spending. We get the data, we give the data back, and that's how we profit. So if right now we're talking to the right people to deploy this in cities like Tampere and others, if you are one of those right people or just simply want to talk to us, come talk to us in that corner and we'll be happy to talk to you. Thank you.
Very cool. Thank you very much. And we've got 2 people to give you your award for this track. Welcome to your friends on stage. We've got Mia Newcourt from Taffy and Jouni Sintonen from Teliasonera. The floor is yours. Take a microphone.
Thanks, guys. What a brilliant idea to use the points. We all love to have points, don't we?
Mm.
So that's a great idea about using the data the way that you did. And I believe that with your app, the mobility as a service will be one step closer. Thanks, guys.
And there's your prize. Give them a big hand, ladies and gentlemen. Very, very cool. Yes, congratulations. Very bright indeed. How many of you have at least once in your life given money to charity? How many of you? Oh, you're a good crowd. You're a good crowd. And this next hack is really about how to make charities more interesting, how to embed charities in everyday life. The track was Creative Charity Track by Nena Paiva. And, how do you bring solutions that, make it more fun, maybe a little bit of humor involved in just say, please help us. Humor, putting it into people's everyday life. And this is exactly what the winner of this track did. They're called Donator. Donator, get over here. Yes. Woo.
Good evening, everybody. We are Donator.io, 4 tech guys who want to use their skills to do good. For this, we took part in the Creative Charity Track at UltraHack, where we created a mobile application for the Nena Paiva organization. Our application provides businesses and charities a way to join together and enable consumers to effortlessly do good. Charities are looking for new ways to reach more people. We want to help these charities in this and bring donating to the 21st century by using familiar features in social media. Smartphones and other devices are the platform for activating people to effortlessly do good.
So, how this works is you walk into a shop, your phone vibrates asking you to check in. As you check in, the shop donates to charity. You will also have the ability to match the donation. We have a real-time feed where you can see what's going on around you. We also have a leaderboard to see who has generated the most donations. What we want is a way to enable all charities across the world to use our app for free. And that is something that we need your help with. We'd like to thank Slush, UltraHack, Nenäpäivä, and our respective employers for the ability to be here. We are donator.io. Thank you.
Super. Do we have the award? Now, there it is. Yes, you, honey, was going to be your award. And you have your teammates with you. Get on stage, you guys. Give them a big hand. It's the whole team. Charities for the for the whole world, making it easier. Juhani.
Yes, on the behalf of Nose Day, Nenä Day, who are currently raising money somewhere to help again others, big thanks to all guys. I mean, the impressive 48 hours. As we know, the raising money isn't easy. And special thanks because you spent your time, even that your normal prices were least, and you still wanted to put your 48-hour effort and before that. So give these guys a special big thanks.
Woo, 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 woo. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. This is close to our hearts. All of us. All of us have already once given money to a charity. Our next track is a very interesting one. How many of you have once been in an empty shopping mall? There was nobody there. Has that happened to you? I'm seeing that once in a while. I'm worried about it. How do we make the shopping experience more exciting by using digitalization, like exploding the concept of what it is to shop for the next millennia? That was the challenge of this track called the Future of Retail track by Tieto. And well, these guys had a great time, a great team with innovative approach. Well, their solution will save us a lot of time, they say, in hassles in stores, making it a lot more enjoyable. Long store displays is our future, and they are... Quno, get over here! You're saving shopping malls. That's fantastic. Good job. Yes.
Good evening. We are Team Quno, and we are here to solve the world's queuing problems, including yours. So, last week, 6 days ago, this Quno didn't exist yet. We asked the users, we thought, tomorrow we're going to go to the hackathon, and we had no idea what we were going to do. We thought we'd go there with an open mind, and we asked our users, what kind of problems do you have? Turns out, a lot of you have the same problems. Turns out that long queues cause aggravation and waste valuable retail experience time. What we then did was we set out to solve this problem of queuing, and we came up with a name, and we called it Quno, deriving from the words Juno, an ancient Roman goddess, queen of the gods, who looked after the women in Rome, and the word queue. So Quno means essentially no more queues. I would like to see, by a show of hands, who of you have had this experience of queuing at this event here today? Slush. Because we were surprised after we came from UltraHack to see so many queues here. Recognize this? Turns out that even the organization itself was apologizing for the long queues. So we're solving this. How big is this problem? According to our estimate, the average person stands in line for 17 days in a supermarket alone during a life period of about 50 years. So what did we do? We designed a kind of a game where people unwittingly participate in a game of keeping the queues as short as possible. And that includes both the visiting audience as well as the personnel. So, Johan, how does this work, technically?
Okay, the technical idea is to use CCTVs inside the supermarket to capture footage of the queues. Then we upload this footage to the cloud where we use image recognition to estimate the queue length. This data is then downloaded back into the store where it's displayed inside the store on digital signage.
So we use the existing?
Yes, we use the existing infrastructure inside the store.
So no hardware is needed?
No new hardware is needed.
All right.
And here's a quick technical demo. Image recognition has come a long way. And here's a picture of a queue I found on Google. And I did the image recognition myself and the estimates around 11 people.
So we actually just count the faces?
Yeah, that's what I did here.
I see. So this is what it could look like on the store's display. Almost every store has a display with a layout or a blueprint where you could see actually the live footage of the queue length. Imagine having that here at the counters. Could look like this here in the back of the store. But it has tremendous benefits because you could actually help the customer pick at which moment is the right moment to go to the queue. So you might want to delay the moment until the queues are soft. I don't see any timer here, but I'm out of time. Shit. Oh, sorry.
Famous last words.
Special thanks to our partners at Tieto. Sorry.
Good job. I'm sorry, man. It's the rules. I'm sorry. Okay, I can't give you more time, though it was fascinating. Thank you very much. Oh, and we have, of course, the Tieto guru himself to give you your reward. Taneli.
Thanks, guys. That's great. We really liked what the team did here, starting with nothing, not even the idea becoming clear yet, and then using these hack methods of asking people to define the problem, going after a thing that they identified, and then using methods like playing on top of existing infrastructure and just hacking it together over the course of the weekend. That's exactly the kind of stuff that bigger companies should take note of and learn from that. Because there's great wisdom in applying these methods, and that's how you change the world, by just boldly doing and not stopping for anything. It's been awesome. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Super. Thank you very, very much. Thank you very much. All right, I want to take another Gallup poll with you. Thank you, Tony. Great job. Thank you. So nice seeing you here. Hey, how many of you shop at least once a month online? At least once a month? Twice a month? Three times a month? Four times a month? Five times a month? You should stop. That's too much shopping, man. Seriously, I mean, take it easy. I mean, come on. Yeah. Well, this track really tried to find ways in which we can make that entire experience of shopping online a lot more fun, a lot more seamless, a lot more efficient. This track was the next generation of e-com track by Posti. The winning team and I saw this pitch. I hardly recognize him. He had a cap last time. Now he looks very clean and collect. You look very good. Are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the super well-articulated solution by Paccy.
Hello. My name is Ville, and I'm here to tell you about our service concept called Paccy, which aims to unify the web shopping experience. Nowadays, the web shops can offer very clean, very beautiful, well-crafted, and well-branded experiences, even emotional experiences. But then, during and after the checkout, something happens. The experience falls completely apart, and suddenly the consumer who was dealing with the web shop is now forced to deal with shipping and banking companies, and the communication becomes scattered. Now, this is a problem for everyone, all the parties included. For consumers, the experience becomes scattered and frustrating. For web shops, well, the checkout is the worst enemy of conversion, and the lack of control over the communication can be a problem with web shops who have very strict brands and tone of voice. And for shipping companies, the communication problems, well, that causes a lot of useless work and unsatisfied customers because the communication just isn't there. But Paccy aims to change all that. Now, Paccy is a service where you create an online profile with web shipping and payment info included, but you put them in just once. You can then use them in multiple web shops. Here we have a prototype of a Paccy plugin that takes over the web shop checkout. You log in, and all your information is there already. You confirm, and basically, that's that. And after that, you can follow all your orders. You can follow them in the Paccy application, the mobile application. You have all your orders there. The new one pops in. Now here you can inspect what's inside your order and all the status updates it has. What's new here is that the web shop can customize all this. All the images, all the text, all the status updates can be customized by the web shop, so the web shop can expand their whole brand to take over the delivery process. And when they actually are ready to deliver, the application asks you, where will you be during that time? So the packages go through more efficiently. To make all this happen, we also offer an application for the shipping companies who can plan their routes based on the Paccy application users, and they have a strict and clean access to all the consumer data of the receiver. So, benefits. Well, for consumers, the experience becomes more harmonious, more unified, and all the communication is in one place. For the consumers, this is free. Of course, the standard shipping fees are there, but it's free. Web shops, well, they have a faster and quicker checkout, and they have a better communication, and they can brand the whole delivery process. For web shops, this is commission-based, so we take a small cut out of every purchase. And shipping companies, well, it's less useless works because they can actually deliver the packages more efficiently, and they have a straight and clean access to the receiver's information. For them, they can use the application that you saw, which is license-based, or they can use the free API to track to integrate this with their own applications and services. That was Paccy, and if you became interested, just find me during the after party. Thank you.
Very, very cool. Woo-hoo! Great job at Paccy. Don't go anywhere. We have a prize for you. Don't go anywhere. There you are, Jaakko, with the prize. Take the microphone, Jaakko, and tell us all how wonderful you thought this was. Hopefully, that's what you're going to say.
This was the first time anybody was hacking any postal company in the world. So
yeah.
It was great
legally,
to be part
legally.
Of this. Legally. It's great to be part of the show. I mean, we came here, we didn't know really what to expect. We had our new e-commerce cloud platform out there. We saw great progress from several teams. You guys took on the APIs, what we had. You really thought well through what's the value proposition for the consumer, for the retailer, for us as a logistics vendor. So you were the clear winners. We loved you guys. And we really want to work with you going forward to see this happening for the consumers. Thank you.
Fantastic, Paccy. Take a group picture with Jaakko. Get in there and take a decent picture of these guys all together. Hyvä posti. Hyvä Paccy. Yes, look happier. Yeah, now you look very happy. All right, we're very good. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you very much. Give them a big hand. You know, I really love it when, you know, big software companies, this is the world's biggest software company, you know, they tend to be gray and boring, you know, start getting interested into some really cool stuff like sports. Any sports fans in the room? Any sports fans? Any Jokerit fans? A few. Any Blues fans? There are a few Blues fans. Any HIFK fans? Hifki? Oh, we have a few. Oh, don't let that influence your decision, Judge. All right? Because the next guy is actually like me. He's a Jupp fan from Jyväskylä. I live there. Yeah! And this app is a super cool app that makes following sports a lot more and more exciting. The track is called Sports and Fan Experience by SAP, and the winner of this track was a really, really cool company, and I'm not just saying that because they are Jupp fans. They were really exceptional in the work that they did. The judges tell us that they were extremely committed to executing the challenge throughout the contest, and what they found is a true love of sport and love of hacking. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Tiimfy! Yes!
All right, Ultra Hack. It's so great to be here tonight. My name is Joona Taskinen, and I come from a startup called Binster. We have designed an app for all sports fans called Tiimfy. What Tiimfy does, it will change the sport world for good. And shit. Sorry, the clicker isn't working. Okay, we'll go without the slides. Well, okay, here we go. I'm a huge sport fan myself, and I noticed a problem. All the things I watch from social media and beyond was scattered. I had to get tickets from somewhere else. I had to get all the news from somewhere else. It drove us nuts. And we decided it was time to change that and started creating Tiimfy. And now we have designed an app that will make it easy and fun to watch sports again. We have designed this multi-sport app where you can, with one click of a button, follow your favorite teams from different leagues, from different sports, all the way from the highest leagues down to the minor leagues. And for all the moms and dads, it's never been easier to follow how your own little David Beckhams are playing. With one click also, you get to follow your social media channels from your own favorite teams. You can have discussions and chats about those. You have all the stats in a nice and graphic way in our app. Also, if you're attending a game live and you miss a game-changing moment for some reason, and you wanna live it again at home, you can do so. You can do so. You can do so by checking your highlight reel for the best bits of the games, and you can live it again. Our business model is based on software as a service because teams need to understand their fans better, and we offer them new ways to realize what their fans are up to and keep track of what they're doing. We have different toolkits for all the teams to help them do targeted marketing and get to know their fans better. We're now looking for advisors to join our team and help us create this globally. And if you're the one we are looking for, you can recognize us by these yellow shirts, or you can find us on Twitter at Tiimfy. Thank you very much.
Super job! Don't move, stay there. Mikke and the team, get over here. Mikke from SAP is going to say a few words. Congratulations. I'm volunteering as an advisor.
Hello. From now on. Okay. Well, folks, I'm really impressed what these guys went about and did. They executed excellently on three things out of which we had wished for two. We had wished for consumption of a statistics API from Liiga that gave them access to extended stats from hockey in Finland, and they went about and did that. And then they went about and put the fan in the focus in a way that exceeded the expectations that we were having, and we're cool with that. But then those guys went beyond what we have stated. They went about targeting a global sports market, meaning that top 10 sports, they have 8 billion fans.
Yes.
And it's a $1.5 trillion market. So guys, talk about business and fans, you really nailed it. So congratulations on my side and give them a big hand. Tiimfy.
Thank you, Mikke. Thank you, team. I'm volunteering as an advisor to you guys. That's a promise. I know international sports really well. I love the stuff. Good for you guys. And our last hack. And then, whoa, this is a really cool one, anywhere, anytime, by Nordea, looking at, you know, people's lives and looking at the multiplicity of financial transactions that can happen in everyday life and seeing how we can make these easier. And one transaction that I personally hate is having to buy a new car. Isn't that a pain in the ass? You know, you have to compare it. But these people found a solution to make this a lot easier, and very, very, very simply, their hack in this track was, and the winner of the track, was Autobuy. Get over here, guys. Tell us how you do it. Yes. Woo. Yeah. Tell me.
Order buying, the easiest way to buy a car. We are the winners of Nordea's Anywhere and Anytime Challenge at Ultrahack. I'd like to start off by telling you the story of Lisa. Lisa is a normal Finnish woman, and she is going to buy a car. Actually, Lisa has already found her perfect fit. Price level, etc. is suitable. However, Lisa is unsure, will she buy the car or not? First of all, the seller of the car is a private person, not a company. Lisa isn't sure, can she trust him? Above all, she wants to validate that this guy really is the owner of the car. Secondly, Lisa knows she will have to go through all the relevant history data of the car in order to make sure there's nothing suspicious with it. Thirdly, Lisa knows there's paperwork associated with buying a car, but she isn't really sure what. She is able to find it out, but actually, she sees it as irritating and time-consuming. Now, we've been talking with people and noticed that Lisa is not the only one who faces these issues. And that's why we're creating Autobuy, the easiest way to buy a car. Autobuy is a web platform which automatically guides you through the buying a car process. Autobuy takes care of the paperwork, gives you a contract of sales, enables digital signature, digital payment. Here you can choose: 1, pay directly; 2, take a loan from Nordea. Last but not least, Autobuy automatically does the registration for you to Trafi. Now, let's take a look at the demo. Timo, please.
Thank you, Robin. Last week at Ultrahack, we made a demo of what Autobuy will look like. And first of all, we just entered her. Could we have the video, please? We just entered the registered number of the car. And then, just after the payment, sorry, there's no video, but I'll run you through. So just right after the payment, we get a nice info on the car. Is it insured? Is it inspected? Is there any problems in the history of the car? And you will be straight warned if there's problems. Like, this car failed its inspection 2 years ago, and you're instantly warned. You can talk it through with the seller of the car. Next, you'll just fill in some basic inputs, like the buyer of the car, the seller of the car, the price. And you'll get a ready-made sales contact that you'll see just in a moment. As you see, really basic input fields reading. And now you have the sales contract here, ready-made for you, ready to be signed. Now is a good moment to preview the document, make sure everything's OK, and go ahead and buy that car. You will be guided to sign the document with bank credentials, make the payment, and handle all the necessary paperwork towards Trafi. And this is how easy it will be.
Thank you, Timo. The easiest way to buy a car will cost 30 euros for everybody globally. We have a comprehensive team. 1 week ago, we had no idea we would be here. Now, we have a place in Nordea Startup Accelerator, we already have a seed investor, and we're pitching at Slush. We are now looking for skilled developers to join our team. Please go to autobuy.fi, check out our demo, and feel free to contact us. Autobuy, the easiest way to buy a car.
Give him a big hand, ladies and gentlemen. Super, and we got the Nordea guys, come on over, guys. Arto and Lauri from Nordea to congratulate you. Yes.
Yeah.
What do you have to say about buying cars so easily now at Nordea?
Yeah, it's almost beer time, so let's keep this short. So, guys, we had a great weekend. You are a great team. Especially, we were very delighted the way how you validated your idea with the customers and how open you were for all the feedback you got. And we definitely look forward to develop this further with you guys. So see you on Monday at the office.
Thanks.
Welcome to our accelerator program.
Fantastic. Thank you, Autobuy. Thank you, Nordea. And ladies and gentlemen, that was it. 17 pitches, 17 teams, 17 amazing projects. Who's going to win? Who's going to win? Very exciting. I have no clue, actually. You just shouted for nothing. I mean, these guys are deciding. I mean, come on, be rational. What's wrong with you people? Okay, we're going to give you työ rauha, as we say in Finnish. We're going to give you time to think. We're going to give you about 15, 20 minutes while we do something extremely important. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to start awarding, as we do every year, the best mobile services in Finland prizes. Who's excited about that? Yes. Who's using at least one Finnish app on their phone? At least one Finnish. Who? Yes. You got to be proud of that. A lot of great apps being developed in this country. There was an annual competition to find and promote the best new mobile services in this country. Winners are chosen yearly, as you all know, from the great apps that are developed in the Finnish market. Isn't it great to have the disco next door? It's really exciting to have that, man. I love it. Okay, the categories in this, ladies and gentlemen, are e-health, fitness, utility and entertainment, industrial internet, direct carrier calling, or what we call in Finnish, mobiilimaksu, and then the main category, the big, the beautiful category of this evening prize for the best mobile service in Finland is the service with the best global potential. All right. The competition is organized by Teleforum and Teknologiateollisuus, accompanied by a large number of companies. The jury consisted of 10 different industry experts, and the chairman of the jury was Minister of Communications and Traffic, Anne Berner. Today we have a representative from the Ministry of Transport and Communications, and she is a unit director at the ministry. She is Päivi Antikainen, tervetuloa! Where are you? Oh, there you are. Olkaa hyvä.
Kiitoksia. Hello, everybody. Ability to create new innovative high-level services is one of the cornerstones of the national competitiveness. Those who are able to create user-oriented, easy-to-use services are the winners in the global competition in the end. This, the best mobile service competition is a great means to promote and to highlight national mobile services and their creators. I think that it also shows that the Finnish innovation is very much alive and kicking. It shows that the users, the customers have been heard, and it also shows that we are brave enough to aim directly to the global market, and we want to be at the top of the global market. So I wish the best of luck to all the people who took part to this competition. Thank you.
Thank you, Päivi, for those opening words. Thank you very much. Give her a big hand, please. Thank you. Kiitos. I got it. Yeah, thank you. Kiitos. Thank you this way. Yes. All right, and we're going to start with the first category. And by the way, this is not a small prize. You're getting up either this Super Lumia 950 for the winning team or the G6 Edge from Samsung. Very exciting prizes, and plus the honor. Oh, there it is. Thank you. I wanted this. Can I get one? This is such a cool, these are such amazing devices. And the winning company, the winning app gets both of these, plus the honor, plus the trophy. It's really, really cool. All right, we're gonna start with the first category, and it's called e-health and fitness. There were 17 candidates in Finland. The top three are the following. Yogaya, Nona, okay, for cancer patients. Yogaya is for yoga practitioners at home. And Sano Kyllä Elin Luovutukselle for transplants. Very, very important stuff. And I will ask Anders, stand back to come over here. Where are you, Anders?
Here I am.
Anders.
Here I am.
Sorry, I didn't call you in time. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, all right.
But
So can we have the winner from Nona here?
It's Nona here!
All right. If not, then on behalf of the jury, I just want to say that cancer is the biggest problem we have as a humanity. There's 14.2 million people dying from cancer every year. In Finland alone, we have 250,000 people diagnosed with cancer. Nona has made a breakthrough innovation in developing a mobile service that helps in the patient healthcare and in the dialogue between patient and the hospital. We are very impressed by Nona, and therefore we want to give Nona this award for best mobile service in Finland for health and well-being. Good luck.
Thank you, Anders Steinberg from If Insurance. Nona doing an amazing, I think they, oh, you're there.
We are here, yeah.
Get over here, get a
Thank
picture,
you.
Get in
Thanks.
Here. Give him a big hand, Nona, yeah. Helping people with cancer, ladies and gentlemen. With Anders Steinberg from If Insurance Company, please. How do you feel?
Super excited. We're just thrilled to be here. And it's a great honor. We're here. The whole team upset our designer, whose wife is giving birth in the hospital, so that's probably excused.
We understand that completely. Onneksi olkoon! Congratulations! Give
Thank
him a big
you.
Hand!
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Super! And now our next category, ladies and gentlemen, is infotainment or utility services. There were 66 companies in this category alone. I would like to ask Jose Fernandez from Microsoft to join me on stage, please. Where are you, Jose? Jose from Microsoft. Here they are, give him a big hand. Jose from Microsoft.
Good evening to everyone.
And now, there were three finalists in this category, Jose. And the finalists were E-Tasku. Could you give me the finalists, please, on the screen?
Well, while they come up, I can tell you why this team won. Most of you...
We don't know yet who won.
But I'm going to tell why they won.
Okay, but don't tell us who it is yet.
Yeah.
But hold on, he's timed it. So we have E-Tasku. So for, you know, e-receipts, getting rid of your paper receipts. 1112 Suomi for the emergency service. And Volt, which was an amazing service for home delivery food. And the winner is... E-Tasku!
E-Tasku!
Tell us why they won.
Why this team won. Most of you for sure already went through the process. Sometimes quite annoying, handling papers to claim your travel expenses or related business expenses. So with the work this team did, you can get rid of all that by just using your mobile phone. When you do expense, just tick a button and then that's it. No more lost receipts, no more unclaimed expenses, and so easy. Thank you guys, wonderful job, keep going. Your Well, these are the trophy. Great job.
Super. Congratulations. Good job. Good. Give them a big, big hand. No more paper receipts. I love this company. I want that app. Thank you so, so much. And then in the third category is entertainment services. 35 companies in this category. And I would like to ask the representative from Sanoma, Hanna Johde, to join me on stage. Give her a big hand. Tervetuloa. All right. Should we look at the finalists together?
Do that.
Let's look at the finalists. And the finalists in these categories were Knomi, a social fashion discovery app. Then Tunemio, practicing music app. And then Ventura, the Uber of traveling app. And the winner is, in this category, ladies and gentlemen, Ventura! Uber of traveling. Hanna, can I ask you, why did we give this prize to them? Why?
Yes, Ventura is an application that encourages the travelers to step out of the tourist traps and to explore the new destinations, new people, new experiences. It has a strong social dimension and it makes it the Uber of traveling and also connects the people traveling and the local people in a wholly new way. Congratulations, Ventura. Very well done.
And they are off to be photographed, and they will be picking up their devices from the picture point in that direction. Hanna, will you take them there with you? Please follow them. Thank you very much. All right, in the fourth category, ladies and gentlemen, we have Industrial Internet, Internet of Things. In this category, it was a tough competition, but with only 13, but great companies in this. And so I would like to ask, you know, Mika Jakonaho from IBM. Where are you, Mika? Yes, come on up, give him a big hand from IBM. If anybody knows something about IoT, it's IBM.
I would hope so, yes.
Indeed, indeed. An amazing company doing a lot of work in this field. So should we take a look at the finalists together?
Let's go, yeah.
So the finalists were in this category. In number one, so we had Haltian, Thing C1. So developer device for Internet of Things. The Indoor Atlas, Indoor Positioning Services. And then Kempi Arc, Mobile Control, Mobile Welding Application. Winner is... Indoor Atlas! Woo! Get over here, guys. Why are we giving this to them?
The cool thing that, about the service is it's based on magnetic positioning, and they made an international breakthrough, especially in indoor mapping. And basically, where GPS doesn't work, this is where this innovation does. So, congratulations.
Give it up your hand. All right, you're up to get the photograph. We can take a photograph here and then a photograph there. Fantastic. Our next category, ladies and gentlemen, congratulations once again, is service utilizing direct carrier billing, which is in plain Finnish, Mobiili Maksu. We love Mobiili Maksu. And for this, I'm going to ask Petri Aaltonen from Ficom to please join me on stage. Give him a big hand from Ficom. Petri, should we take a look at who are your finalists in your category right here? Let's take a look, shall we?
Yeah.
So, we have Tori.fi, so a free online marketplace from Finland, as many people know. Feli, the new payment method, and especially for bus tickets in Turku. And then Netiauto, online car classifies. And the winner is... Feli! Tervetuloa, turkulaiset! Congratulations. Why did we choose them?
Feli is the perfect example of a service in which Mobiili Maksaminen is the most natural way to get payment done. Easy and safe for both end user and the merchant. We are looking forward to see something like this in the Helsinki metropolitan area too. Congratulations.
Give him a big hand! Woo! I got it. Yeah, you gotta put it like that. All right. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment we've all been waiting for in this competition was the service with the best global potential. 27 Finnish companies were battling for this top prize in the best mobile services in Finland. And I'm going to ask Marko Nurmela from Samsung to join me on stage, please. Marko, please, come on up. Give him a big hand. Samsung, you know that company, don't you? An amazing company. We're going to look at the finalists.
Yes, absolutely.
Let's take a look. Who were the finalists? We had, it was Yogaya doing yoga at home. Then Ventura, again, an amazing company. And again, the Nona, the cancer, the patient treatment. So, the winner is... Who can it... Yogaya! Woo! There they are, get over here. Onexolko. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Yeah, this award goes to a forerunner in online and well-being applications. It provides a personal guided service, live yoga classes and wellness classes through your own webcam in your homes. We definitely see a big international potential here, and that's why the award goes to you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
That is fantastic. Give a big hand. Take a good picture. Oh, I have a question. Take a picture first. I have a question for you. You are our big evening's winner from Finland, the most
the greatest potential, the greatest international potential from your service. Yes. Could you please tell us something about the service? I mean, yoga at home, how does that work? You can take those.
It works really well. And I think it's the,
show
I
me!
Mean, thank you so much for this. I mean, it's been so great working with such an innovative concept, and especially with a team that is so passionate about bringing positive change into people's lives. We launched the app 2 months ago, and now we have users in over 50 countries. And the biggest credit really goes to them,
countries.
To our users in all over the world, because with them and with their help, we've been able to develop the service. So, thank you.
That is super cool. Hey guys, can I take a selfie with you?
Absolutely.
Looking at the audience, are you ready? I'm sorry, I now you know my passcode. Don't tell anybody. Are you ready? Get in. Everybody start yelling back there. Closer. Yes, thank you very much, thank you. Congratulations. Yoga at home, 50 countries already. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is really the moment we've all been waiting for. We're gonna ask the member, did you wanna come and say something for Ultra Hack? Miko, the super Ultra Hack man is on stage.
Hey, are you excited? Yeah. Ultra Hack, are you excited? Yeah. Are we gonna win? Yeah. Yes. I would like to thank all the Ultra Hackers, our partners, our great contestants for the amazing competition we had, and it was not a competition, it was a community working together, engaged together. So I would like to give big hand to all partners, all contestants, all volunteers, all people involved with the production. Let's give a big hand to Ultra Hackers! It's an amazing crowd, it's an amazing setting. I would like to ask the volunteers, all the production team, come here on stage. Please come up here.
All the volunteers, everybody from Ultra Hack, get on stage now.
Involved with the Ultra Hack.
A family portrait, get out of here.
Come on, we need a photo.
It was an amazing weekend in Ultra Hack.
Yes, all people, even Juhani, come on.
Juhani, get there in the middle, Juhani, in the middle. In the middle, on the ground. In the middle, on the ground.
Yes.
Okay, now everybody say, Ultra Hack!
Ultra Hack!
Woo, 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 woo! Give him a big hand, ladies and gentlemen. An amazing team, amazing Ultra Hacks. Unbelievable weekends. An unbelievable week for Finland in hacking.
Thank you. You are amazing, too.
Thank you. All right. Now we have a little small piece of business is, who's gonna take this home? Who wants this? Do you want it? Do you want it? Do you want it over there? Anybody? If nobody wants it, I'll keep it for myself, you know. It comes with 20,000 euros tonight for one of the 17 amazing hacks that we've heard tonight. I want you to give a huge round of applause for all 17 pitches. Oh, everybody, weren't they amazing? Woo! Amazing. They were just amazing. Unfortunately, the rules of the game is only one team can take this home with 20,000 euros in their pocket. And now we await the announcement of the jury. Gentlemen of the jury, please join us.
Sure.
I'm going to give.
Thank you so much. It's been awesome. Thank you very much, Slush, for arranging this. This is the first time, and boy, has it worked well. So thank you very much for joining. Let's give a big applause for Ultra Hacks and Slush one more time. Thank you. And here with me, I have Timo from Adventure, Tim from China all the way, and my name is Klaus Mikunils from FIBAN. We had a hard decision choosing the winner from all the 17 awesome who had been through the stressful, too much pizza and Coke, but we love the one. But we have one winner. and we're really glad to announce, and hopefully the entrepreneurs will hear it from here as well. Ladies and gentlemen, I think it's time to announce the winner. The best marketing name ever, it is, the winner of Ultra Hack 2015 is Slush Smackdown!
Get up
Come
here!
Come on stage! Ha, ha.
Everybody up! Come on! Woo, woo, woo. Amazing!
Awesome.
Good job, man. Good job.
Good job.
Woo, 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 woo. What a hack! What a hack!
Who was the prize?
The motivation for winner. We had a lot of great opportunities and alternatives, and hopefully many of these will become great startup successes. But of course, it's a time of getting into coding. Let's share the good word and enjoy the good gamification model of coding. So congratulations. Hopefully it will be a big one and have the main stage next year. So congratulations. Big applause. All right, let's party!
Let's party! Thank you very much, everybody! See you next year for an even bigger hack for Helsinki and Finland! Thank you very much! Bye-bye! Aivan mahtavaa, onneksi olkoon!